full tank. Oh yeah, I'm packed.
Next stop, Ashland, Oregon. Well, let's do this.
This is gonna be the first trial run.
Sign
heating up lunch. It's not as warm as I'd like it, mainly because I'm in a hurry to eat. Oh wow. Just dickered. I'm hungry though.
Oh, look at this. Would you just look at it? Would you just look at it? Beautiful. Sure, there's nothing, but it's just not raining. Mount Shasta, coming up on weed, California. Listen to him. Some John Fogerty. All right, we are 6 miles from Red Bluff. We've gone 216 miles on, well, it's sloshed around, but that should be way over there. I basically get 270 miles and, you know, there's 30 miles to the gallon. Probably gonna get a little less. We climbed a lot of hills after that last fill up, but yeah. Well, starting to wind down the day. This weather is just great. Damn it, where do I hang of it? This temperature right now is very comfortable. I'm probably gonna hate the salt sea for a little bit, but you know what? I don't care. I'm on the road. That's all that matters. Dude, I'm so happy with this truck right now. Also, I guess my work is holding up. Cruising along at 60, speed limit 70, but there's not a whole lot of traffic and people are gonna go 90 anyway, so whatever. Well, I am, where the hell am I? Pull up my map here. Bitch, where am I? I am in Williams, California. I'm, just at a rest area here. I think I'm gonna sleep for a little bit. So I'm having a bit of a snack before going to bed. And I got these, oh my God. Nah, there we go. Stray cats.
Meow.
My Solar World t-shirt shifter boot. It was not tied up on one particular spot, so as I was driving, air was blowing up through there. Thankfully, this engine and transmission don't get as hot as the old gas setup would. Oh my God. But I was just kind of letting this thing air out. It was a little warm.
Well, yep, kind of figured I'd get a zit building up on my lip. Don't you hate that? You're like getting ready for a job interview and it's like, fuck you. I was sleeping really freaking good up until this asshole next to me and this stupid Toyota Corolla decided its alarm was gonna go off. Alright, we're headed to Santa Paula. Apparently, I've used a little more than half a tank. I don't think that's right. At empty, there's 12 gallons left in there, so we still got quite a bit in there.
Okay. We're about a half tank of fuel. Let's fill it. Let's see what kind of MPGs we're getting right now. I think this will probably be the last time I fill it. By the way, I've been running this stuff. Take declined. And we're off. It's filling perfectly fine. I need to put in my zip code for Oregon. Okay, so like 11 gallons. That's interesting. Man, we weren't even the way my sender's set up, it's gonna be pretty deceiving. You're gonna be like, oh my god, I'm getting like 8 miles to the gallon. So I don't really need this fan right now. So I went to 315 miles. Divided by, let me put 11.3. Yeah, I'm getting, this is what I'm getting right now. 28 miles to the gallon. Yeah, so I lied. I'm getting close to 30, but I'm rounding it up. But in case you're wondering, the exact number is 28. I'm doing the Ford thing. Oh yeah, it's gonna get 40. It really gets like 36. All right, we're in San Fran. I can't really give you a good shot, but we're passing Alameda right now. I kinda took a wrong exit, so I did a little bit of a loop, but this is pretty freaking cool. Never been over here before. Focus on that.
time I was here, it was nighttime. We pulled over and slept for like 2 hours. So the grapevine, I think we're gonna miss it because we're on the 5 right now, and I believe the grapevine is on another highway. Let's see, we're going south. It's west. Yeah, I think it's east. I'm not sure if it's 580 or what, but it's out that way. So I think we're gonna miss it, which is fine. But I think we'll get it on the way back. We'll try and hit it on the way back later in the week. I'm just kind of resting. I'm a little tired, but give the truck a little bit of time to rest. And I'm just kind of standing up, stretching. I'm letting the foam in the seat kind of pop back up. Oh, I want to refoam this. Still somewhat comfortable, but passenger side is definitely a lot more better. But yeah, I'm gonna do a little preliminary check under the hood. I know one thing I got an issue with is I'm getting low on washer fluid. Well, we're almost to Santa Paula. I have to pee really bad. Just thought I'd let you know that. In the last clip, you saw we made it to the grapevine. We did it. Hell yeah. Says I'm almost out of fuel, but I've got about 15 gallons. 15, 16 gallons left. Actually, I think I have more than that. Because when it's right at empty, there's 12 in there. Alright, so I had to go buy sunscreen. I was getting burnt just driving in here. Okay, I just filled up. I put 19 gallons in, and we were just about on the empty mark on the gauge. So that meant that we had like another maybe 16 gallons to go. So by the time I hit the empty mark, we would have 12. So we got 430 miles out of that, and we climbed the grapevine with that tank. We ended up averaging 23 miles to the gallon. So, you know, I'm not going to complain. It's a 105 horsepower four-cylinder diesel with, and it has to push a bulky, heavy truck up a 7 or 8% grade for like 15 minutes. So that took a good chunk out of our mileage. Otherwise, after that, just cruising, you know, it's we're back to, you know, 28, 30. You know, it's really good. It's pretty damn close to what my Mazda 3 was getting. All right, I am fully rested. It is Tuesday morning, 5 a.m. We're gonna fire this baby up, and not with the fan right now. It's actually kind of cold. Yeah, I started up just fine this morning. We're going back to the starting issue from when it was acting weird, and we were thinking, oh, maybe it's the injectors. Well, I'm starting to think maybe my hose clamps for my front fuel tank were starting to get loose and probably letting a little bit of air in. I'm thinking that's what it was. Because now I'm running up that rear tank and everything's all fresh and stuff, and it's fine. So, yeah. I got my idle down just a tiny bit, and it's, she's cold. I don't usually shake this much. Well, it's warm enough. It's about, 9-something right now. I knew the time, but I forgot it as soon as I looked at my phone, so you know how that goes. Yeah, about 100 miles away.
away from our destination. But yeah, it's a little warm. Air feels about 75 to 80. Actually feels cooler than that. I don't think it's quite that much, but however, it's a little bit warmer in here because I got this insulation and I don't have my other window rolled down a little bit, so. But I'm not sweating or I'm not uncomfortable. I'm actually kind of enjoyable. Alright, we're like 60 miles from Calexico. And I tell you, this engine really enjoys this weather. I don't have any vibrations. Quiet despite the window being down. The ride is smooth and cushy. The truck likes it out here.
Look at that. I mean, you could go as far as you could possibly make it.
I mean, you can go on for days. I'm not gonna do that. But man, you can have some fun out here. I'm not gonna go too crazy. I don't have a spare with me, and so you got all these rocks here. These are pretty sharp, you know. I think these will tear into a BF Goodrich. But yeah, if I didn't have my trailer hitch here, I would have probably crushed that fuel tank, or actually probably would have tore my bumper off. But I'm gonna give the truck a little rest here. I'm kind of let my butt cheeks pop back out of my body, and yeah, it's actually, the temperature is really nice right now. It's like It's hotter in my truck than it is out here. I mean, it's cool. There's this light breeze. Now granted, it's, you know, end of April, so once middle of the summer rolls around, it'll probably be about 100 something out here. But look at this. We are out here with our Ford truck. Man, I cannot believe I'm out here with this thing. Yeah, this is awesome. Now, one thing I wanted to check. Okay, fuel tank isn't getting warm. That's good. I got a little bit of dribble of something, but I know my transmission is gonna need a topping off before we go. That's the only thing that's really leaking. Other than that, everything's good to go.
Stupid, I gotta go. Well, it's now Wednesday. Hanging out. I've been over to Mex a couple times. Had a little bit of fun over there, and then my friend is over here checking the fuses on his van, but it's actually his radiator's blown up. I recorded the grapevine climb with my camera phone, and an SD card died, so I lost my pictures I took on the trip, but at least I have them from Facebook and whatnot, so I have some there, but I lost my video, so whatever I got in here is what's left, so we'll do some video on the drive back. Didn't miss a whole lot, nothing really special happened other than the grapevine, but the grapevine, it ate it. I did like 70 miles an hour up the hill the whole time. No problem. But yeah, it's doing good. Nobody broke into it and stole my stuff, so went over last night, parked it in some scary neighborhood. It's the only good spot to park that wasn't parking meter or, you know, do not park at this time kind of deal. And I'm almost out of water. One problem I'm having is my door handle over there, when the door's locked, and I have it like this. I lift up on it, it's like really stiff for a little bit, and then it gets undone. This one used to do it, and it stopped. I don't know what's up. Stopped doing that after I lubricated the lock, so maybe that side, which is exposed, might need a little bit of lube. Whew, she's a toasty one. I'm glad I brought these. I'm actually, just said my goodbye. I'm gonna head out a little early. Yeah, I gotta get back. Yeah, I had my fun and got to visit and whatnot, but we gotta go on. I'm burning up. I'm surprised I haven't gotten any redder. I'm actually doing all right. I've been out walking around. I was out in Mexico for a little bit and clean my truck, or at least the windows. So yeah, there's a little bit of water spots, but yeah. Oh, somebody commented about when we did the welding, leaving pits on the windows. Yeah, we totally did, but I already told my cousins, like, I don't care if we get pits on the windows. I'm putting a new back window in. I am definitely getting tinted windows. No way. Thankfully, I have somewhat of a vent so I can keep some air going, but this is gonna suck dick. Got my electric cooling fan on to keep her a little cool, but I think I'm about to put some sunscreen on. I might as well do that while I'm waiting. Yeah, we got a check station up there, so it's gonna be a little while. Dick. Oh, dick. I see traffic. Scenery. This can suck. It's definitely a lot cooler. I'm not sweating anymore, so that's nice. My back dried up. My bottle of stuff I've been putting in the fuel tank is, I don't know if it's letting the vapor out. I'm kind of smelling it. I'm freaking out. So I think when I fill up, I might just chooch the rest of that in there, get rid of it. Tired of smelling it. Smells like squashed bugs. Correct me if I'm wrong, but back on I-5, I think we're hitting the grapevine again. I won't get this one on video. I don't have my camera thing set up, but yeah, I'll let you know how it goes. Oh shit, we're going up a hill. We're going up a freaking hill. I don't know if she's gonna make it. Yeah, right. I went and put $24 and got 7 gallons out of it, $3.05 a gallon. Practically put it to a full tank. I don't know what I'm getting for mileage. I don't really care anymore. I figured it's around 30, so. Fine with me.
signals still work, but I don't know what's up with that one. Maybe one of the light fixtures dangling around could have something to do with it. I'm gonna hit a rest area, take a break, and take a look at it.
I don't know what's up with that, but checking the wires, I got them kind of all cattywampus, so not much I can do, but alternator's still charging, so nothing's goofy. I would assume that the running light wire is probably starting to touch the turn signal wire. That's the problem I have with my last turn signal sockets, which I'm not using, but they're still there, so I don't know.
Turn signals work, so
I'm gonna kind of stretching, taking a break, cooling the turbo off. We just came down from the mountain. I don't really think it was that hot, but. And then I've got that voltage regulator up in this corner. If I tap it, I go back to normal oil pressure, and the coolant temp thing is not right. It's running really cool. Tap at it again and it just goes back down to normal. So we're gonna tear all that out and make a whole new cluster, something I've been wanting to do for months. So here's one problem I have. My media entertainment center is not working. My amp's not even turning on. And I've got my wire that feeds it all has one big fuse. It's good, and the fuses on the amp are good. And that switch here turns this light on, which turns that on, so what gives? Now it works! I just started driving and it came on. I got some electrical gremlins. Starting to turn into a goddamn GM. Alright. The other side is going up the grapevine. We're actually going down it. That guy has no brakes. That Dodge right there, he has no brakes. That's why he's going flying on the hill. I'm doing like 55. I'm maintaining it. Beautiful. People are flying around me like, son of a bitch, this Ford actually can stay at a decent speed. Everybody's doing 80 miles an hour riding their brakes. I smell so much brake shit right now. Yeah, see? Grapevine. Grape fucking vine. That's what we're doing. The grapevine. Uh-oh. Getting Sony. Focus, you little prick. Eh, it's not gonna focus, but I had to pull over for a little couple minutes. My headlights are shutting off, and part of my other issue is my radio wasn't working earlier, and popped the hood and the stupid negative on the battery was loose, so I went and tightened it down, and they've been staying on, so I figured I lost ground, and my gauges have been all wonky, so pretty good, so yeah, I might get a different ground connection on that and then solder the cocksucker to it. Get the old torch. Yeah. Well, just plugging along. Hopefully I don't have to pull over again to fix my headlights. Okay, roadkill update. That little turn signal thingy majigger going on. God damn it. I have done popped a fuse for, because I have no backup lights. I got no, and here we go. I have spare fuses. So I'm like doing little ignition resets and I'm just like, what the hell? I got nothing. Let's see. Yeah, see, it popped it. Well, I took that little turn signal thing and moved them over, and I put two wires through them, so they're separated. I think they were touching, and it finally killed it.
I blew the emergency on too. I should have taken my whole ignition stuff from the last column and put it on this one. This is the first time I've had this little problem here. Okay, we're working there. And we got brake lights. So. Turn on that light. Occasionally works. All right. So that's about 15 amperes. So yeah, I blew these two. Okay. Scared the shit out of me. I'm out of gear. Will we start? It's in gear, takes off. Headlights. All right, we got lights. It just occurred to me, I'm in the middle of fucking nowhere. I mean, there's nothing. I'm on Highway 46, getting ready to cut over to the 101. I'm gonna take that Salinas, San Fran, and all that good shit. And then, we'll probably cut back over to I-5. Maybe. And then Clem Falls. It's our next destination. But I'm gonna find a rest area and hit the sack. I think I'm gonna go pass out. So I'm about 20 miles from Paso Robles. Cruising along on this little Highway 46, and boy, you'd never know there was a Cummins under the hood. It's really quiet, really smooth. It really likes that 3-to-1 ring of pinion. I thought it hated it at first, but yeah, this is nice. Oh, rest area, 1 mile. I think I'm gonna hit the sack. Area. But yeah, this thing is really smooth, right? The ride is smooth, the engine's smooth. It's fantastic.
Alright, I'm having issues with that stupid ground connection again. It's like being weird. My lights were turning off again just as I was pulling in. As soon as I took it out of gear, it was like click, click, click. I'm like, fuck. So before I leave in the morning, I'm going to clean that ground connection. Actually, by the time I wake up, it'll start being light. So, yeah, that's something we're going to have to deal with. Other than that, it's not something that will stop me from driving. Other than if they just went out completely, then yes. I'm here at the rest area, so I'm just going to... I'm going to pass out. I'm so tired. Okay, so I took the negative off, and connection was getting a little corroded. It had like not the green crap, but because it's been off fairly recently, but it had a little bit of film on it, oxidization. So I just cleaned it off, and see if it does the same thing. They were working. Oh, it's weird. Okay. Okay, the one's going out. Let's check this jazz out. Okay, now I got it to work there. The connector that goes into the headlight pigtail is falling apart, so I've undone it and plugged them all in as spades, but okay, you're not gonna be able to see Jack diddly squat. There you go. I've got two sunshades, and I've got them both set up. I got my little cave going on, and I'm going to freaking bed.
Good morning, Vietnam. Oh, looks like the battery is just now dying on my camera. So, yep, sure is. Well, I'm gonna have to break out the charger because I'm gonna need it. Anyway, it's about 4 o'clock. I'm gonna probably start heading out here in a little bit after I wake up. And it's cold. Damn, I should have brought a blanket.
Okay, we are on our way to Weed, California. We're still we're kind of in the neighborhood of San Francisco, but we're on the outskirts of it, on the 101. But I just had a nice meal at Denny's in, I forgot where I was just at. Oh my God. I don't care. I'm leaving. Anyways, somewhere along the 101, there's a Denny's. Put it that way. You know, they had the best coffee there that I've ever had in my life. I don't know what they were using. Even the dude there, I was like, what coffee are you using? Like, that is the best stuff I've ever had. As at least any restaurant goes. And he didn't know, but it was really good coffee. I had like 2 cups, which really woke my ass up. But I needed food. I was getting really tired, so I had like a sandwich and some hash browns, and oh man, I just feel so good. So I got a full tank now. I also filled up there. It was a little expensive, but better than 4 gallon. I paid $3.21 and I put 14 gallons in. And that put it right back up to the full mark, but it didn't let it click. It was probably gonna take like 16, or it was just like, you know, 14's good. It's really windy. Like, OMG. Wind is still blowing pretty damn good, but I'm behind this Winnebago. And I got the boost pressure down, so that's good. So I'm gonna coast behind these fuckers for a while, and then eventually I'll have to get out behind them. But right now this'll save me some fuel. Alright, just for kicks, I put filled the tank on this thing. I went 300 miles on 12 gallons of fuel. It's 25 miles to the gallon. And pretty much all of that was in a headwind. Except for the last part. For about 50 miles, I was behind a Winnebago. We're not so much into the headwind anymore, but got a slight hill to climb, and I'm still making less boost than I was in the headwind. So that's pretty good. Alright, I'm about 60 miles away from my destination, and basically in Weed, California right now. There's construction up ahead here, and yeah, it doesn't look like we're gonna go anywhere for just a little bit. Yeah. Gotta go. So remember this little dash top thing I bought and haven't made a video on to put it, how to install it? Well, I'm not even gonna bother because I don't know if you can tell, but the fucking thing's warped. It got warped in sunlight that we would get in Oregon on a good day. I don't even want to buy the door panels from LMC truck, to be honest with you. Some of the shit I've been getting from them is, like, just god-awful. Like, oh my god. Like,
I want new door panels, but if I drop like $300 on them and they give me shit that can't withstand Oregon sun. I can't.
But hey, look at the fantastic view.
To a friend's house, Medford. Glasses don't fit my face properly, so it feels weird. I did a little rearranging of my headlight wiring. So I've got my headlight running the high beam circuit. They seem to be on still, not shutting off. They stopped doing the shutting off thing when I disconnected the fog lights. I think they were starting to put a big load or something on it. So that's hasn't been an issue yet. But I've had the connectors are fitting there loose so they don't fucking connect right and the light won't come on. So I'm gonna end up on taking those out and soldering them together. And then that way there won't be a connection issue. But we're into a friend's house, winding down the trip. We got basically 200 miles to Portland, so it's no biggie heading back. Just look at it. Wait, Jeff, look at it. Engine humming along at 50 miles an hour. I think it's 55 or something through here, but just cruising. This is just beautiful. Holy shit. Don't fucking crash. Oh my god. I gotta go.
Well, in Medford. Slept really good. It's about 8:30. Went to bed at like 11. We got 275 miles to go through to get home. Yeah. You can tell she's cold. Look at my steering wheel. Yeah, it's like 50 degrees. Started up just fine.
I'm not having that starting issue anymore. I haven't had it all week.
Bits of my old dash coming off from the road. This thing is all warped now. That's just fantastic. So my friend's a truck driving man. He's a red Kenworth. I'm looking for a red Kenworth. I think I see a red Kenworth. I gotta go.
Well, I caught up with him all right. I turned around, waited, and we saw him, and then peeled out of there and caught up with him about 10 minutes later. Stupid no left turn getting back onto I-5 North. I'm like, screw you. I turned around some dirt field and then made a right onto I-5 North. I'm like, what the hell, you know? Screw you. But yeah, I caught up with him. That's pretty funny. Impeccable timing. I'm ready for lunch. Well, started losing power up in the hill, all right? And engine just dies. And has ignition. I got fuel. I don't know what the hell happened to it.
So I got my friend just pulled over somewhere. I think he's on his way down. Yeah, that sucks. yeah, I'm just gonna let it sit here for a little bit. See what's up.
All right. Looks like the injection pump's got some issues, so
let's just go home.
Poor baby.
Marathon.
Swear there. Yeah.
Customized coaches.
Oh, there she is. That poor baby.
She's home. Check the injection pump's not too happy. Yeah, this guy saved the day.
Only $750.
But it's home. Now we gotta just
fix her up.
Well, as you've seen, I have made it home. Unfortunately, it was a very costly expense. Unfortunately, it looks like my injection pump has gone out, and I think the reason why it's gone out is because of that additive I've been using. I put a little extra in, and I'm starting to think that maybe that I probably shouldn't have ran that particular additive. In fact, it really doesn't need any additives. I was just put it in there a little bit to the idea was that, to lubricate things a little bit better. And, I think, something in that additive probably ruined my injection pump. I'm hoping it didn't, grenade and send, metal bits into my injectors, because then we got to do injectors. So it looks like we're probably going to borrow the injection pump from Adam's engine because he still hasn't put it in yet. I'm going to borrow it to see if it is, see if it'll run with it. I didn't want to do it, but I sprayed a little bit of WD-40 down the intake and, the engine fired up and it ran until it ran out of, WD-40. So, probably not the best thing, really, to get it started. In fact, I know, ether is, terrible. It'll get started, but it's really hard on the engine, and I only did it for a tiny bit, so I'm hoping that didn't do anything to it. Sucks. It's my only vehicle, and I gotta fix it, but I got a bike, and work is close, so. I am thinking of taking someone up on their, idea for a GoFundMe page for my basically my YouTube channel. I still have a lot of things I want to do to the truck, and now I've got something I've got to fix. So, I'm a little behind, and then I've got that tow was pretty expensive, set me back. So whatever. Hey, the truck's here. And I still have a form of transportation, so. Anyways, it was still a fun trip, and it was worth it. I enjoyed every bit of it. I love being on the open road, and I especially love being on the road in a truck. And the truck did really well up until the ending there. I'm thinking that maybe that additive finished off the pump. Probably within the next couple of weeks, I'll probably borrow Adam's injection pump just to see, if it'll run. I'm pretty sure it will run with a new pump, because I checked the lift pump, it was sending fuel up. I tested it, it had, good flow, it was just gushing out, so I'm sure that was fine. I got plenty of fuel coming out of the fuel tank. It was, I had 20 gallons left, so it got fuel. There's no air. The clear fuel filter I have showed, that there was no air. It was all solid with fuel. Anyways, tubes, we got some work to do, and I'm going to start a GoFundMe page. I'll end up posting it somewhere, and
and you know, a buck or two wouldn't hurt. And it's not just to do this repair, it's just for my channel altogether. You know, it costs a lot of money to goof around with my truck, so yeah. Anyways, thanks for excuse me. Thanks for watching, and I appreciate everybody's support and suggestions. Everybody's been pretty helpful throughout the time of watching me tinker with my truck and make or break things and all that good stuff. Anyways, have a good one.